Today we're talking about the Italian election, a country that is currently going through the geopolitical equivalent of a chicken with its head cut off. Yes, my fratellis and sorellis, it's not looking great right now. As some of you remember, the primary vote happened on March 4th of this year. Alright, that's about 3 months ago. I would think things would have at least kind of worked themselves out by now. Well, unfortunately.
After weeks of talks and hopes of a breakthrough, Italy's prime minister-designate throws in the towel. Giuseppe Conte had been asked by the so-called populist coalition, which between them won the most seats in the March election, with forming a viable cabinet. Now he says that's proved a bridge too far.
Really? Forming a viable cabinet is a bridge too far? That's literally the first step. That's like me abandoning a board game because I couldn't open the box. I mean, this isn't brain surgery. Although, if it were, you should talk to our cabinet member for the development of housing and urban development. Because, despite the fact that we make really weird cabinet appointments right now, at least we're putting someone there. So, alright Italy, one of the few countries that has somehow transitioned from fascism to, well, no one person having enough power to get anything done, what really happened? Well, to begin, we need to look at the election results and how the Italian government works, or is supposed to work. So first, how do Italian elections work, in theory? Now, I did a previous episode on this a few months ago when the election actually happened, but I'll be brief and use different jokes. Alright, so not all democracies are the same. In Italy, you vote for parliamentarian parties, and the party that gets the most votes gets to run the country. Sounds simple enough, but unfortunately, Italy has more parties than a sailor on leave. So, much like an argument on the internet, very rarely does someone actually win. Alright, so what does that mean? Well, to have control to pass things, you need 50% of the votes, which the most successful political party in Italy right now has 1/3 of the vote. Yeah, with 1/3 of the support, you have about as much political impact as a change.org petition. Huh, 100,000 people think Donald Trump shouldn't ban Muslims. That'll show him. Alright, so how do you get to that beloved 50% mark in order to achieve basic government competency? Well, you form coalitions with other parties. Because if there's one thing Italians and politicians are known for, it's being good at compromising. It gets even more fun when the two largest parties combined are just enough to pass that 50% mark. And guess what? They're both populists, so good luck getting one of them to surrender to the other. It really wasn't a good sign when we heard directly after the election the leading party say,
"But Five Star have vowed not to do a coalition deal with anyone else. In a country in which you can't do government without a coalition, it leads many to wonder if they would prefer not to be in government at all."
Well, he doesn't seem too hard to negotiate with. So now let's fast forward to today to see what's happening. The Five Star Movement, you remember the ones that wouldn't make a coalition, made like a movie character vowing to never do something and immediately did it, forming a coalition with fellow populists, the League. Which, wow, how did you come up with that name? I couldn't have picked a more vaguely evil-sounding political party if I was trying to. A vote for the League is a vote to kill the Batman. Those two parties bonded over their mutual hatred of immigrants, and are definitely going through a honeymoon phase right now. When the moon hits your eye and you hate all black guys, that's authority. Alright, so what's the problem? I mean, besides the fact that liberals in these countries aren't exactly pleased with these revelations. It seems like we have a government. Well, nope, because if you remember from earlier, the man who they both agreed to designate to be Prime Minister just announced,
"Prime Minister-designate Giuseppe Conte gave up his bid to form a new government."
Alright, so why couldn't this coalition put together a government? Well, it's because of the Italian president. Now, don't get too comfortable with that term, because in Italian, the word president means something completely different. This guy's job is to just kind of keep an eye on things, make sure nothing too absurd happens as far as appointees. Now, he okayed the prime minister and all of the appointed cabinet ministers, except the economics minister. Let me tell you, he okayed some pretty wacky people too, but this economics minister must have been a real problem for the president to draw a line in the sand. So what's the problem? I mean, how crazy can you go with economics? Well, according to the president, the proposed economic minister had ideas that probably or even inevitably would lead to the exit of the euro. Yeah, that might seem underwhelming to non-Europeans, but an Italian Brexit would have some pretty big implications. We'll call it quibbly. The stated reason for the president giving for vetoing the position was interesting, because it wasn't actually based on a desire to keep Italy in the EU, but rather a desire for government accountability, saying that this was a fundamentally important choice for the prospects of our country and our young people. If one wants to discuss it, it must be done openly. Basically, when they were campaigning, neither of the coalition parties said anything about the Eurozone, with the Five Star Party being intentionally ambiguous, something that's a lot more charming in a romantic comedy than a presidential election. Basically, because they hadn't taken a stance on this, he argued that to take such an abrupt and radical stance was undemocratic. It would be like if Donald Trump nominated a new head of the Federal Reserve whose main position was to take us to a doubloon-based economy. I'm sure that would help him secure the people in bunker vote, but that's a pretty important thing to know about when you're electing a candidate. So where do we go from here? Well, surprisingly, this one unfilled cabinet position voids the entire Italian government. Chaos is ensuing with the coalition arguing to impeach the president, and the president setting up a temporary leader until Italy can have another election. Essentially, if it's broken, just replug it in and hope it doesn't crash again. Now, generally, this would be resolved by proposing an alternative economics minister, but the leader of the Five Star Party has said he will not compromise. Because apparently he's so passionate about leaving the Eurozone that he entirely forgot to mention it even once on the campaign trail. Alright, so first, let's look into how to impeach the Italian president. According to a translated version of the Italian Constitution, the president may be impeached by Parliament in joint session, with an absolute majority of its members. Now, absolute majority might sound daunting, but it's just a 51% majority. Not sure why they felt such a need to spice this up. Honestly, I'm a little surprised how easy it is to impeach an Italian president. I mean, those guys should be dropping like flies. In order to impeach this president, all they need to do is get everyone from the Five Star Movement and the League to vote together. Although, some are doubtful that the coalition will be able to stand together because of how flimsy the case against the president is. But I have faith. Now, in the meantime, the Italian president has...
The president may ask Cottarelli to form a technocrat government.
Yes, he's going for a technocratic government. Because if there's anything that's a terrific response to populism, it's a bunch of eggheads with no political experience locking themselves away to solve the country's problems. Also, going to the IMF for government help? That's like getting cooking advice from Hannibal Lecter. The IMF eats debt-ridden countries like you for breakfast. So it looks like you might not want to put too much effort into creating a great technocratic government, because it might get voted down before you even have a chance to post the Craigslist ad. That's because this caretaker government has to get the majority of votes in two different groups that are both controlled by the coalition to be approved. Alright, great. So if the populists don't get their cabinet, and the president doesn't get his cabinet, then what the heck happens? As you can imagine, it's not ideal. Parliament goes into recess, and the agreed-upon prime minister will run the show until September, when Parliament and the prime minister will be dissolved, and there will be new elections. So there you have it. Italy, a country that's in a battle royale to see which branch of government is the last one standing. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, if you want to support nonpartisan comedic reporting, please subscribe to my channel and like below. As always, thank you for watching.